Hi guys, merry day after Christmas. I hope everyone had a beautiful holiday. Mike and I are sitting down at the river, drinking our coffee and feeding the birds. I'm gonna do a video clip later of some of the stuff I got for Christmas. I don't think I can do all of everything I got because I got so much stuff. Shout out to my family and especially Mike's parents. They always go above and beyond. I got some really awesome gifts from everyone, and everyone always goes out for my nephew too. I really appreciate that. He had an amazing holiday. He couldn't be happier. It just sucks that the day after Christmas, so many places are open now and people work, and Stanley had to go to daycare today, which really sucks. But we are gonna finish our breakfast and then we are gonna go down to South Street. Mike had a pair of sneakers on consignment with a, what's the name of that shop?
Suplex.
With a shop called Suplex, and they've actually, those shoes have been there for a year. What shoes were they?
The Flips.
He had a pair of Flips.
The Jordan Retro 3 Flips.
Jordan Retro 3 Flips. Mike is a shoe connoisseur, collector of all Jordans and retros, and honestly, he has boxes from the floor to the ceiling. So he had dropped a pair off to this guy at Suplex, and they've been there for over a year and they finally sold. So we're going to go down there, maybe see some festive stuff is still out and decorated, and just enjoy our day and relax. All right, guys, I'll talk to you later. Hello again, on our way to South Street. I just love being in our city. Philadelphia is such a beautiful city, and you just get a whole different vibe when you're down here. I really love all the buildings and the art and the culture, but we're ready to start our afternoon. You excited, boo boo?
Yes, I am.
He looks so thrilled. Oh my gosh, guys, we found our heaven store. Look at this.
They got Frodo Baggins. Oh, they have the yellow Power Ranger for Stanley. It's only $5.
Oh, he likes... Yeah, hold on. Incredible, right, guys? This toy store, I love it. Little vintage store for Sandler.
$3 each.
Buttons. Gag gifts, like the cigarette burns, stuff like that.
Tracy. I used to have these.
I love the keys. Look at, you seen the watch parts?
Yeah, it's crazy, right?
Oh, what's that? Boo!
Boo!
Hi guys, so don't mind the face mask. I'm trying out a new hydrating mask. Got some on my lip, definitely. You know what? We're just gonna go with it. You know why? Because that's life. And that's why I wanted to do these videos, because girls are not always done up. This is how we stay looking good. We work on it. But I just wanted to end this clip. I forgot to mention, today while we were driving around and whatever and going out, we were driving down a street and this little poodle is on the sidewalk and he's digging at an empty McDonald's bag. And I mean, the bag's completely flattened to the ground. There may have been a fry left in it. And it was all old and tattered, and you could tell he'd been out in the weather. And this poor little poodle is like ripping at it and gnawing at the corner of the bag. And he's like following the bag out into the street at this point. So I tell Mike, I'm like, stop, stop, stop. And anyone who knows me knows I'm like an animal lover through and through. If you don't like animals, there's something wrong with you. Definitely. I don't trust you. There's something off. So, oh God, this is really bothering me. Hold on, guys. I'm sorry. Damn, this shit is like paint. Not coming off. Crazy. So, I realize, you know, we got to get out. This dog's probably a stray. He's cutting his skinny. His claws were long. His teeth were really white, and he had a collar, though. So, I'm like, The dog, as I'm walking towards him to try to get him, and I'm like trying to, I had a bagel, I'm trying to get him to come for it, and he wants to come for the food. You can tell he's hungry. And I threw him a piece, and he ate that. He's backing up, and he's walking up a stairwell. So I'm like, okay, this is definitely someone's dog, because the way the street went, the properties go stairway, walkway, then the door. I knock on the door. First off, it takes like 10 minutes, and the door was cracked open, and I could tell this little gate for the fence was open. So I was pretty sure this is where the dog lived, because he was barking. He was like up on the stoop with me. And finally, this guy comes to the door, and I was like, hi, is this your dog by any chance? And this was him. He goes, yeah. Cha, get in the house. No thank you, no nothing. Like, if someone returned my dog, I would be over the moon, like, thank you so much. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Thank God he didn't get hit. And I told the guy, I said, hi, you know, is this your dog? He was on the street. It looks like this gate is open, you know. And he just didn't give a shit. And I thought, how crazy is that? And I don't know, that was still on my mind. And I was thinking, gosh, the dog was probably better off if I took him. But I would never do that. That's horrible. But that's all I have for today, guys. Hopefully tomorrow I can get in the video of the